Nicole. I'm from Dallas, Texas, and I have a Great Swiss Mountain Dog. We got him from a breeder in Houston, Alpenglow Swissies. Sherlock has champion bloodlines, both of his parents are champions. We have shown him before several shows, but he didn't really enjoy it, so we stopped. He won a couple of shows, and came second and third in others. Eve, my husband, chose his name, and it was a name that he used to use when he was gaming when he was a teenager. The Swiss Mountain Dog isn't actually as popular as you would think in Switzerland, given that he's called the Swiss Mountain Dog. But they became very rare at one point because they're really a farm dog. And so, you know, less and less people had farms and then ended up with less and less dogs. He's really protective, really good with family. He has a lot more energy than your typical Great Swiss Mountain Dog. He's a really, really good family dog. He loves his family, but when it comes to strangers, he is very protective. He's very protective of the house, so he's a really good guard dog. But with that, you just have to draw the line and be a strong owner and be the leader of the pack. They're not an easy breed to raise, so some experience is probably needed with large breeds. During the week, we take him out for a walk, probably about 20 minutes in the morning. Then he has his breakfast. And then he waits at home while we're at work. I work from home 2 days a week, so he sits underneath the table and watches me work when I'm at home. And then when we get home, he gets some cuddles. And then once the baby's in bed, one of us will take him on another 20-minute walk. And then he'll have his dinner. And then he'll chill with us in front of the TV and get scratched behind his ear and on his chest, and then we go to bed. Oh, I wish I was a dog.
We've come a long, long way together through the hard times and the good. I have to celebrate you, baby. I have to praise you like I should.